Do you feel ready?
Yeah, I feel like I channeled my inner raptor pretty well.
Hey, mamas.
Family edition.
Today we're going to see if the 2023 Ford F-150 Raptor
is the right full-size super truck for your family.
Let's start with this fun fact. The Raptor is 8 feet wide. Holy moly. And by law, you have to have these three orange marker lights because of its width. Just to give you a reference point, the average width of a vehicle is less than 6 feet. That's intimidating. And so is this blacked out Ford grille, your LED headlights, DRLs, and turn signals. You have LED fog lights down here, a steel bumper, and the R gets these orange red accents for the badge, tow hooks, and graphics. Ooh, and you have these little lights to represent the supercharged V8 underneath that hood bulge. There are skid plates underneath for protection, and I love this antimatter blue metallic.
Yeah, it's really cool because it looks black in shader at night, but then the sun hits it during the day and the blue just pops. It's so cool.
That's sparkle.
Oh, that's you? That's you sparkling and popping?
Sparkle. To keep up with that oversized theme, you have 30, oh.
Okay, what happened? You tried to bounce off it. Oh my goodness.
You know I do that. You have 37-inch all-terrain tires on these 18-inch matte black beadlock capable wheels. Could you just explain what beadlock capable wheels are?
Yeah.
Come on.
Sure. Okay, so when you're airing down the tires for off-roading, if you screw in beadlocks on these wheels, then the tires won't unseat themselves from the wheel. Is that good for you?
Yeah. Thanks for explaining. For some of us mamas or dads.
Who think it's just a dance? Beadlock capable, beadlock capable.
Raptor.
Oh gosh.
Did I look like a raptor?
Yeah, for a second there, you scared me. The Raptor R also gets these metal side steps that are rhino guarded for durability and provide you some protection when off-roading. You get these LED spotlights on the door mirrors, which you could direct by just moving the door mirror. And then also pretty much every F-150 gets this keypad system. So you can leave the key in your truck, set the code, and then do things keyless. The Raptor only comes equipped in the Crew Max configuration with the 5.5-foot bed. And the Raptor R gets these graphics that have the red R on them, which is great if you've got a contrasting color like this dark blue.
I think it looks more orange, but yeah.
Red-orange R. Okay. There's also, on the Raptor, the Fox Live Valve Remote Reservoir Suspension System. Really heavy-duty stuff. Year-round back, this one doesn't have the optional power tailgate, but it still gets a dampened tailgate, so it won't come crashing down on you. It has a spray-in bed liner. It's got some tie-down points as standard and LED lighting to see things well at night. It also has a 400-watt AC outlet to power things while camping or at the job site. And you know what it doesn't have?
A step.
It does not have a step. The power tailgate version does have the step that comes down and a grab handle to get up and in easier. This one doesn't. So even for me at 6 feet tall, I still have to hike my hip up over, then climb in and do it that way because otherwise there's no integrated step. There's just on the bumper and nowhere to grab. So it's just awkward to get up and into this truck.
Yeah, and thinking about this as a family vehicle, kids are not going to be able to get in and out.
No, so you're gonna be hiking them up and down every single time. Now looking at the tailgate, I like the Ford stamp there and the Raptor badge with red-orange accents. The Raptor R can also tow up to 7,450 pounds. It's got these metal recovery points, these 3-inch darkened exhaust outlets, which make a mean noise, and you've got a full-size spare tire hidden up underneath. The taillights are also LEDs with LED turn signals.
Looks good.
It looks really good. Okay, in summary, Christina, how cool do you feel driving around in this truck?
Unmatched levels of cool.
It's like a big kid Tonka truck. It's awesome. It's meatier than a Silverado ZR2. It's more proportional with the big tires than the Ram TRX. We have to ask the audience. Okay, guys, do you think this is the coolest looking truck in its class? Let us know in the comments.
First off, inside, everything you're going to see is standard on the Raptor R. You can add a panoramic sunroof, We don't have it in this trim.
But I would add it. If I was going to get this truck, I would 100%. Because it makes it so much brighter in here.
That's
kind of dark.
That's true. Yeah.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay, you have a heated leather wrap steering wheel with some contrast stitching. You have these aluminum paddle shifters, a digital gauge cluster with some fun animations. But there's no head-up display or digital rearview mirror. And I really love that feature and would need it in a vehicle this size.
I mean, the blind spots aren't that bad. But yeah, if the cab was full it would be nice to see right through those with the digital rear view.
Yeah. Down here you have a 12-inch touchscreen and it's fast enough, but the icons and things are not laid out the way I would want them to be.
And when you've got the wireless CarPlay or Android Auto going, it's only on this part of the screen. It doesn't come over here. This is its own little menu section. I wish it took over the whole screen.
Absolutely. I do like that this camera is easily accessible up there. You also have a bed cam, which is super helpful. Woo!
Monitor your stuff while driving.
Go do a break dance back there. Me? See your best move.
Okay.
Wants to move, but don't break your back.
I wish it was easier to get up here.
Oh, okay. Boy.
Oh, I'm in the tree. I'm literally in the tree. Back really hurts today.
My back hurts. Did you hear that? Oh. What is that? And that's all, folks. Down here, you have your physical controls for your climate and media, your drive modes, and two-speed transfer case.
Trailer brake controllers above that, and then the Pro Trailer Backup Assist kind of removes the confusion of when you're with a trailer, you're thinking, turn right to go left when you're backing it up. But with the Trailer Assist, you can just turn the dial and the trailer will back up in the exact trajectory that you tell it to.
Handy. Over here you have a 12 volt and an AC outlet, and under your carbon fiber, a gnarled finish, you can slide that back to see your wireless charging pad, two USBs, an A and a C, and then over here you have a slot where it's nice to put your phone.
Yeah,
right? You put your phone there. Watch this party trick.
Look at that.
Just kidding. Okay, open this up and now you can change your bebé. Aquí.
That's how you would use it. Most other people probably like have lunch on here, put your laptop, get some work done, hook up to the Wi-Fi hotspot.
Mm-hmm. Do a little content posting, do a little coding.
That's how you do that?
Send. But wait, there's more. Storage, that is.
Oh, goodness,
yes.
Whoa,
deep down, move this aside, and you can see you have a USB A and C.
You just want to dive right in there. There's so much space.
Oh, God. Down here, you have more storage. You might as well put my bag there and press this for even more.
Bye-bye, carbon fiber. Hello, space.
Let's look at the door panel.
Oh, yeah, they are huge. We've got lots of space here. You can put big water bottles. You can put sunglasses, other junk.
Snacks. Gotta have the snacks. Mm-hmm. Up top, you have 6 pre-wired auxiliary switches for accessories like lights, sunglass holder, and a sliding rear glass to ventilate Miles's farts or pass items through.
Hey, speaking of passing,
especially on a road gassing trip. Okay, now to the seats. Hey, no sleeping on the job.
These seats go so far back, and they're so comfortable.
Nice.
These big Recaro buckets with leather and suede. They're heated and ventilated too, Christina.
Oh, no massage?
No massage.
That's okay.
It's okay. Power adjusting.
Ooh, bring it back up. Get ready to rock.
So far away. Squirrel over there in that tree. Nice squirrel.
Hopping into the back, you have this side step here and a grab handle, which is great for adults, but not toddlers who like to do things independently.
Yeah, it's really high off the ground, so you're going to have to help them up onto the side step, and they can't reach that grab handle.
Right. Seated at 5'9", I have great leg room. I do wish the seats would extend a bit more for some thigh support, but I have great headroom. In the center here, you have heated seats, cup holders up top, a DC outlet, 2 USBs, an A and a C, and another AC outlet. Woo! Oh, can't forget more cup holders in the center. The cushy armrest. To the door.
Okay, we've got this fabric-like material up top with that orange-red contrast stitching. Carbon fiber here, just like we had in the front. And otherwise, it's kind of plasticky down here. You do have some padding for your armrest. There's a Bang & Olufsen sound system. Really nice quality sound system here in this truck.
For piling those kiddos in, well, 3 of them, you have 2 sets of lower latch anchors on the outboard seats and 3 tethers Look alive!
Oh, what the? It's a fake baby.
Partner, Tess, with the car seat in.
Honestly, I'd never noticed there was a kid behind me. I've got so much legroom and headroom, I don't need any more.
All right, show us why mamas want trunks.
The storage, that's definitely why you want it. Even things like map pockets, these are massive. You could fit a couple big water bottles in there. And then you've got versatility. You can lift up the seats, and depending on how many kids you've got back here, you can lift up all of them if they're not with you. And this giant surface area is perfect for putting a dog bed in and having your dog come along with you. Or maybe even a double stroller. Let's see how that fits.
No, you're not. Put this.
You could do that. Actually, could close the door like this.
Yep.
All right, so there you go. There's your double stroller and double kid space.
Now,
another thing you could do is lift up the seat bottom. You can expand this and lock it in place. Then put the seats back down. And this is lockable storage here.
Hide things from your children.
The eye of the raptor, it's the thrill of the fight.
Rising up to defeat other dinos. That's as far as we got.
I really do feel like you are the king of the Cretaceous period. You the raptor are.
Oh.
It was literally spinning its tires right there. 37-inch all-terrain tires, and we're spinning it because we have 700 horsepower and 640 pound-feet of torque from a 5.2-liter supercharged V8 motor. That's routed through a 10-speed automatic gearbox and sent to all four tires via a part-time four-wheel drive system. Right now, we're in rear-wheel drive, and that's why we're spinning the tire. You can go into four-wheel drive for off-roading.
Which we're not going to get super into because you have a review of you off-roading the Raptor.
I do, yes. If you want to see it doing jumps, which I did, and it just kind of tearing it up off-road, you can watch my review on that. We are going to be talking about mostly what it's like to drive on the road. And I know you've got some thoughts, Christina, driving this big, big hunk around the road. What's it like?
I mean, we already talked about the width, but
feet wide.
You are really going to notice it on the road, right? You're going to be like feeling like you're close to other vehicles. But I will say that I was very surprised by the turning radius.
As I will now demonstrate, which you won't be able to see, but we'll just sort of describe with our facial expression. It's got a very good turning circle for a full-size pickup truck. So here it is cranked. You need two lanes to turn around, and that's really solid if you're planning on daily driving this thing, using it as a family vehicle. You do not want to be having to make like 50-point turns in parking lots.
No, it's super comfortable. Like, I really like these seats. I am like extended out. Like, I have plenty of room here with the car seats in. We have two car seats back there. Everyone's comfortable.
A lot of that is the ride comfort.
Yes.
This rides so nicely for a full-size pickup truck. A body-on-frame vehicle that usually is moving around a lot. The rear axle is usually kind of like hopping around. With the Fox Live Valve suspension system here, it is just taking all the punishment of the platform and the road and just distilling it before it gets to us.
And visibility. I don't think there's any blind spots in here.
Not really. I mean, the pillars aren't that thick.
No, which is nice though.
We mentioned that it would be nice if you had a digital rear view mirror, but the door mirrors are good sized and you've got the blind spot on our turning system working for you. And the steering is fortunately pretty responsive, so you won't find yourself floating too much if you are locked into what you're doing. You can stay in the center of those lanes. You also have a lane keep system, so you can use that at kind of any speed, and it's gonna be just monitoring the lanes, and if you do start to float out, it'll push you back in. But if you have that system on, it's working all the time because it's so wide.
Okay, goo-goos.
Yeah, but it's not going to scare you to drive this vehicle on the road every day. The transmission is really nice. It's smooth between the gears.
What would you say about brakes?
Just like the throttle, I think they're very easy to adjust. Like, you're not gonna have a very grabby response from the brakes, but slow, progressively, and smoothly. Other daily driving concerns. You're probably worried about how much noise is being generated.
Or maybe they're not worried, but their neighbors are.
That's a good point, yeah. So fortunately, you do have several different exhaust modes, including a quiet mode, and you can set the vehicle to always start in quiet mode. You can set the time parameters, say between the hours of 11 p.m. and 7 a.m., where it's always gonna start up in that quiet mode. So your neighbors won't be quite as upset.
Irritated.
Yeah. Another livability point would be the noise that's generated from those all-terrain tires. So some all-terrain tires are just making a considerable hum, especially at highway speeds. And
this hum is not really all that bad. Mm-mm. What you do get is a fair amount of wind noise that enters the cabin. It is just such a big block that's kind of pushing itself through the air, so that makes sense.
Let's talk about safety. Okay. So you have automatic emergency braking with forward collision warning. You have blind spot monitoring and rear cross traffic alerts. You also have
adaptive cruise control with steering assistance. And when thinking about it as a commuter, those two features are really going to be handy for you.
All right. For fuel economy, you're looking at 10 in the city, 15 on the highway, and 12 combined.
It's so painful.
I was like hearing those numbers, I'm like,
Yeah, but the one thing I will say is it's a 36-gallon tank. Getting that 12 combined MPG, that means you are having over 400 miles in a tank. So you're not filling up all the time, but when you are,
yeah.
36 gallons at California gas prices, which are like $6 a gallon for premium that this truck requires, would be $218. Brutal. That just ongoing cost will add to the, what, $109,000 starting price?
Yep.
And this one, as tested, is $110,000.
But let's talk about the competition.
All right.
So you have the Chevy Silverado ZR2, which is going to start around $71,000, so significantly less money, and it makes 420 horsepower and gets 15 combined MPG.
There's also the Ram TRX, and that is more of a direct rival to this truck. So the Raptor R specifically. So the Ram TRX is $86,000 to start, still less expensive. It makes 702 horsepower, so two more horses.
Oof.
And it has fuel economy of 12 MPG as well. So it's not gaining anything there, and it's just as wide, it's just as imposing. So while our infant is entertained by a water bottle, which she may have just dropped, and so we'll see how long she can last, we can talk about how much we've been entertained by this F-150 Raptor R. It's been such a great truck. There are only a few things that are really tough to deal with. The starting figure.
The fuel economy.
The fuel economy, yes. And three is just the size.
But you could get used to that.
And everything else says this truck is worth it. It's
yes.
So practical. It's so comfortable. The power is incredible.
I like that you're sitting up high.
Yes.
Like, you feel safe in this vehicle.
Yeah.
I love the space in here, and I know a lot of people say, oh, you don't need this like as a mom, but honestly, like, I appreciate all the storage spots. I love this like desk area / baby changing table.
I give it a metaphor of kind of like a bigger house, right?
Yeah.
You don't really need it,
you
right?
Need
but
it, yeah.
The moment you have it, find a way to use the space.
And you enjoy it.
Yes. That is the biggest part to the Raptor R. If you're not buying this truck to have at least a little bit of fun, then this is just going to be the wrong vehicle for you.
Need Raptor arm.
Raptor arms? Don't. Okay, ready? Okay, ready? You next time, see you next time. Ah! Ah!